Today's adventure starts in the Launceston Zoo.
Which most of us have fairly low expectations of, I have to say. You kind of expected, you know, tin pot kind of...
Piss weak world. I am a little bit funny about zoos, as I have educated myself a lot more in, you know, the treatment of animals and how zoos...
Kind of expected it to be, you know, two little cages and, you know, something over there, maybe a cow or something. We didn't really expect the... It was fantastic. They had lots of big cats.
And for the most part, I applaud Launceston Zoo. Your spaces for the animals seem to be very impressive for the most part. First, we stopped in Asia.
What'd you find, Lil?
A wee room.
I want to move it, move it. I want to move it.
Then we had Africa.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God. And the pinnacle
of Africa was the lions.
Oh, that was yours, was it?
Oh no, I'm just saying that was, you know, the big thing was the lions.
Really? For me, the giraffes. I loved the giraffes. You know how in a zoo, people sort of have they kind of go to a cage, they go to an enclosure, they look for a certain period of time.
They stand there for 5 seconds. I can't see the animal, then we'll run away.
But I don't even know what that period of time is, but they kind of move on, they give up. And I think when you go to zoos or have these experiences, that you push past that point where you sort of go, okay, I could walk away now, and to just sit and just take in the animal.
That was so cool.
That was breathtaking, actually.
It was.
And that is what I did at the giraffes.
They had, what else did they have? They had...
have to talk about the lions. So did you know you should never ever whistle in the jungle? You should never whistle in the jungle to a pack of lions. Went off their chops when this dude walks past and he starts whistling to them. Now, when we were at the zoo, naturally being, you know, in Tasmania, it's going to have a good percentage of native animals.
Thank you.
We were faced with this very difficult challenge, which brings us to the next question of how does one feed an emu? I think you had the most success. Yeah.
And one of them just wanted to chase you around.
I'm not feeding you.
Ow! This one's the friendly one.
There you go, hold your hand out. You can do this, Jillo. Just hold your hand out, Lil. Hold it. It can't see it. It needs to see. That's it. That's it. Oh yeah. Alright. That's better.
What are you doing? You're about to get far rammed, you too. Yeah, Anna. Yeah, I got you. You're
am I meant to feed him with my hand?
Yes. Oh. Or just put the bag out. Hold the bag out for him.
Let's just
do that. Because it might take.
Yes.
Come here.
Okay.
You were much more polite earlier. Oh, look out.
Oh my God.
Well, it is a ram, so.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna be careful.
Oh, look, the little donkey's come over.
Would highly recommend Launceston Zoo.
Absolutely.
For a family day out. They're not skimping on the care for their animals, their enclosures, and the variety of animals that they're getting there. So
Want to live too close to it though, because it would be rather noisy.
I'm hanging out for when they get zebras. Thank you again for watching, and
we will catch you on the next adventure.
Sheepy! Ba! You a good sheep? Are you a good sheepy? Will you bite me? Please.